What's up, everybody? It's Tim, DJ High Noon, your friendly neighborhood vinyl dude. So, sorry, thought I hit my turntable on. Apparently, I turned it off. I'm an idiot, and I need to have background music. Not because I'm an idiot, but I'm just. This has been long overdue. This is like one of those updates that I've been working on and cleaning and trying to get through. If you've been watching Billy Hurst channel, you'll know that he is in Jupiter, Florida. He is a photographer for the St. Louis Cardinals. And of course, now everything's coming unglued because we're all going home and being forced to stay there. Anyway, but he made a trip from where he lives on the outside of St. Louis, kind of through Tennessee and Georgia and Florida, to get to his destination, which is in Florida, which so you kind of got to get through it. Anyway, along the way, he did some stops. I was lucky, honored, and blessed enough to be one of those stops. He came into Orlando 2 weeks ago. Myself, Billy, and Brad, H2Vinyl, spent the day together ripping apart the town. We went record shopping. So, I'm just jumping into this. I got a lot to show. I'm going to try to do this in one video. And because I finally got some metal to show, I'm playing this because Bev is always so sweet to watch most of my videos, or at least some of my videos, and she's like, I have no idea what the hell you're showing here, but good on you for being happy. So, Bev, I'm playing this in the background for you. I got metal coming. Let's go. All right, so we hit 5 stores. I'm going to do them in the order of the stores, so if you see a heavy hitter early, I got lucked out. So, we met up early Saturday morning. He had just gotten off the road. He was actually changing into some more comfortable gear when I pulled in. Hellos, pleasantries, hugs, belly bumps, whatever. And we hit the road. So first place we went is a staple here in Florida, in Central Florida. It's Park Avenue, CDs and More. And I ended up picking up 3 from there. We didn't want to go crazy. I knew where we were going, and I knew some of the stores were going to be known for heavy hitters. But I had to pick up a couple things. Stayed in their value section for this one. This is In and Out of Focus from Focus. I think it's a mid-70s reissue. This was originally reissued in 1970. This would have been before they really hit it big with the Hocus Pocus, which I think was on... says it on here, Moving Waves, and then Focus 3 and stuff like that. Still great prog. This whole day was heavy for prog and heavy metal for me, so I was extremely happy. So Focus, In and Out of Focus, great stuff on the Sire label. Just having me glancing over at their new arrivals in the 357 section, and I kind of did one of those, I'm sorry, did you just show me that? You surely did, Mr. Accept Balls to the Wall. I mean, I can't let that sit there for $5. Vinyl looked great. There's a couple issues with the cover, but Accept Balls to the Wall? no, you're coming home with me. So I was glad to pick that one up. And then out of their main pre-owned section, I grabbed this one. This is the Electric Prunes, Mass in F minor. I don't see Electric Prunes a lot. So glad to finally get something on vinyl from them. Interesting psych, prog-ish, I guess. It's more psych than prog. But this is actually composed and arranged by David Axelrod, who also produces the Electric Prunes. If you've watched my channel, I've talked about him before. I'm a huge DJ Shadow fan. DJ Shadow was very influenced by David Axelrod on his first album. So I try to, and whenever I see him producing jazz or psych, I try to grab it. So I know he's produced Electric Prunes for a while. This is very, it's funny, it's mixed with some good psych with some hymnal elements. Like you hear very, almost Latin chant out of them, but still really good. I was glad to pick it up, very clean. So that was my pickups from Park Ave. Not too far from Park Ave is one of my heavy hitters. Brad and I know Alex well over at Foundation. We see him regularly. He probably has the numbers in my bank account. So went in there. He still has some remnants of this big collection that he had. A lot of it wasn't in the best of condition, so he was selling those at five a pop. He's got some really good $10 and $20 sections, so I kind of checked out there a little bit. And then I brought home a couple hitters. So out of the $5 section, I was very happy to pick up my first of two from this band, the Michael Janker Group. And this one is Built to Destroy. A little bit of damage here, but the vinyl is almost mint. I mean, it's got a couple of slight marks on it. And this is actually a UK pressing. So I was very happy to get that one. Hell of an axe shredder Michael is. So glad to pick up some MSG for a fiver. And then from an 80s nostalgia period, some Men Without Hats, Rhythm of Youth. This has the big hit Safety Dance on there, where we're all going to walk around and, you know, we'll dance if we want to. But if your friends don't dance, I can't know. So, fun stuff. I'm glad to pick this one up. Like I said, you know, it was, I don't even know if I've ever even heard the full album in its entirety. But, you know, they had a couple copies. I kind of picked the cleanest one. So for $5, that's what I knocked the record down. For $5, I wasn't going to say no. Then he actually cut me a deal. So I went back to the $10 section because I had these and a couple of those and a couple of others. And I was going, all right, I'm done. He cut me a deal and I went back to the $10 section and picked up three because they're three for 20. Saw this one, this was the first one I saw, and it just jumped the hell out of me. This is Bo Diddley. I wish this was an original. It's not. It's an 80s repress, and it's a gold stamp promo, so we'll take that. Vinyl was beautiful, so and the cover's in really good shape, so glad to have this just classic Bo Diddley in my collection. If you're not familiar, there are, well, I'm trying to reduce the glare, just some killer tracks on that, worthy of being in someone's collection. Another one I picked up from that section, Black Sabbath, Technical Ecstasy, not their best, by a long shot. This was their seventh, so it was the first one right outside of the big six that they did, kind of the beginning of the end for Ozzy. But I'll be honest with you, it's not a bad album. I don't think it deserves some of the slacking it got in the press. But then again, you know, critics are very jaded at times. But music is personal. So, hell, if nothing else, the track Dirty Woman, the way it ends, is worth it alone. So, like I said, cover not in the best of shape. I may upgrade this down the road. Vinyl's okay. So I wasn't mad at it. Glad to add it to the collection. And then out of the $10 section, something I really need to focus on is some Van Halen. And I, you know what, unpopular opinion? Yes, I said it on camera. I like Hager better. What are you gonna do? Poke me?
Right here. Do it. Right there. Right there.
It doesn't matter to me because although I like the Van Halen years, the Van Hager years, I thought the songs were a lot more intricately written and better performed. I've seen both of them live. I've seen Van Halen with David Lee Roth and Van Hager, and I had a better time at Van Hager. Could also be the Alice in Chains open up. I don't know, but you do the math. So then, one that I knew he had, it had been sitting there, and I had to kind of, last time I was there, I put it back, and I said, look, if it's here again, I'm buying it. And he's like, it's probably going to be here because people keep asking what this gem is, and they don't know. So I finally got a copy of Jade Warrior. I wish it was a Vertigo Swirl. It's the second press that's on the Vertigo Spaceship label. This is amazing psych prog. So Jade Warrior kind of formed out of remnants of, I think one of the guys even came from July when they broke up. And they had a 3-4 album run on Vertigo, and then they went to, was it Atlantic? I don't remember. But I mean, they were recording well into the 90s and 2000s. After a while, they became more of an instrumental band. But three-piece, great stuff. It's hard to explain. It's like one of those things I would love to do a needle drop on them, but I don't think a needle drop does justice. So the full album is on YouTube. I don't know if it's on Spotify as well. But it's a three-piece band. You have guitars, you have bass, you have some flute. And you have percussion, not a drummer. Percussion, it's more congo. It's more, more the percussion side than an actual drummer. And it adds a very unique element and allows some of the space into the music to kind of be free. So really enjoyed this one. I'm glad to finally get it on wax. So if you're interested, definitely check this one out. I'm after their other two on Vertigo for sure. So glad to finally have that one. And then the other one that they get regularly, and I've missed it a couple times, but I wasn't missing it this time. This is just happiness on wax for me. Absolutely adore this album from Kraftwerk. This is Computer World. This is an original 81 press. Was very happy to get this one. This was my very first exposure to actual Kraftwerk. I had heard them, well, later on I found out it was them being sampled in some of the early hip hop, but you know, when Numbers came out, it really just, the creativity blew me away. And it was there that I fell in love with Kraftwerk. Started here, found out they had more, worked my way back, worked into like Autobahn and Trans-Europe Express, and the love just began. So definitely want to continue to add more Kraftwerk, but I'm very happy to finally have this one in my possession. So that was Foundation. Small store, always has heat. So then I think we went to lunch, which was funny because the vegetarian recommended the barbecue place. You do the math. Anyway, so we had a great time just sitting there chatting. And then we made the trek out to Triangle Vinyl. So Triangle Vinyl it's in Central Florida, but when you're talking about like Orlando proper, if this is Orlando, Triangle's somewhere over here in Claremont, and it's a ways away. So it was a great thing after lunch, kind of just let's relax, let's recharge. We talked a lot about music. We were sharing things in the car, like, hey, play this and play that. And I actually ordered something that we talked about in the car. So that's coming up too. So we got the Triangle. We all go our separate ways and start looking, hey, do you have this and this and that? So I started in the $5 section. He has a $5, 6 for 20. No. Yeah, I think that's it. Or 5 for 20. I don't care what the hell it is. and I flipped through the whole thing because I haven't been to his new store. He's got a newer location, and I only found one, but man, what a one it was. It's the Robert Cray brand. Who's been talking? This is originally released in 1980 on was it Alligator? Tomato, excuse me. The original release in 1980 on Tomato. At this point, I think he was done with his contract with Polydor, and he got signed with Atlantic, and they had rights to some of his older albums, or were buying the rights and reissued it. They actually remastered this one as well, so it sounds very clean and very open. Phenomenal stuff. If you're not familiar with the Robert Cray band, just his amazing style, you're doing yourself a disservice. Great 80s blues. He's got cuts on here from Willie Dixon. He's got stuff on he's written. He's got, excuse me, just some killer stuff on this one all around. So Robert Cray brand, who's been talking, loved it. I'm glad to pick that one up. So then I started doing some general digging, and finally found a copy of this Queen in the Wild. That's Genesis, selling England by the pound. Absolutely love this album. Probably my favorite from the Peter Gabriel era. If not a damn close second. So I was glad to pick this up. And now I think I'm under 5 studio albums to completing my Genesis discography. Except for Calling All Stations. I did not like or care for that one at all. So, excuse me, I'm going to pass on that one completely. But this one, absolutely glad to finally have it on vinyl. And like I said, getting closer. Found my way over to the New Arrivals bin. And I saw that he had this one a couple days prior. And I get it, he doesn't like to hold stuff. And I didn't want to bug him or reach out and say, hey, we may be up there. But it was still there. I couldn't believe it was still there. Excuse me, I swear it's not a virus. It's just a sore. It's just a allergy thing. But pick this one up. This is General Giant Octopus. It's a reissue. Doesn't have the die cut there. However, very clean. Plays real quiet. So I was very happy for that. Also, Bill from the Vinylverse, who I owe a contest entry to, I'll be doing that this weekend. If you didn't know, in April, the first 4 albums from General Giant are getting reissued on A La Carte Records, and that includes the very first one that wasn't available in the States, and they all have the original artwork. So if you've always wanted the Three Friends artwork with the original artwork in the UK, not the reused artwork that we had on ours from the very first album, you can get that. You can also get Octopus with the greenish color cover, stuff like that. So I will probably end up getting, I already have Acquiring the Taste, and it's a Vertigo. So that one I'll probably leave alone. But I'll probably get the reissue of this and of Three Friends down the road. So they're going to have the covers. And then I did pre-order the original one because I don't have it at all. So glad to have that one. Another for the for my General Giant collection, which is starting to grow small, but it's smaller, but slower. But a couple metal ones. Monom, Discard of Timekeeping. This is just great 80s hard rock. This one I think got kind of pushed aside in the 80s because everybody was like, it's Bottom Sun, it kind of resembles Zeppelin in takes, but you know, on their own merits, they were a great band and just absolutely killer stuff. The big one that they had on this one was Wait For You. But I remember I bought it because of that single back on cassette in the 80s, but I wore the hell out of this one out. So I'm glad to have this one wax. So, and then another one I just don't see that often and I have been looking for, and it's not that it's terribly expensive. I mean, I got it for $115, but I just don't see it. So when I saw it, I giggled happily and that was Kingdom Come's debut. Great German blues rock. Again, they got a Zeppelin comparison, and I never understood why. I mean, Bonham I kind of got because of Jason, but this one I never understood. But still great blues rock from the 80s. Was glad to pick this one up. Killer stuff. Really worth your time to check it out if you're not familiar. So I don't know anything after they were off Polydor. So I think they did two more on Polydor, which I'm trying to track down. But anything after that, I'm not familiar with them. And you know, that's what it is. But I'm definitely trying to track those down, but willing to, if I see others, I'm going to grab them. And then my last pickup from there was one that I had been desperately wanting to pick up, but held off on it. And I was kind of glad I did because, man, was this thing just ever mint. And that's the latest from King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard, and that is Infest the Rat's Nest. Great stuff. Love this album. This is thrash done right by a psychedelic band. You do the math on that. This is a killer album. Go stream it if you're a thrash or metal fan. You probably won't like the rest of their catalog. It's just not it. But this one will rock you. I guarantee it. So I was very happy to get adding this one to the collection. Killer stuff. And that was it from Triangle. We made the trek back to Orlando. We hit up Rock and Roll Heaven, which I really wasn't feeling anything in there. I know Billy did pretty well in there. He did really well in Florida. Just some of the stuff he was pulling, was like, good God. So it was getting late, and Brad was actually kind enough to kind of show for everybody. So I had been dropped. I was just dropped off there. I didn't have no need for me to park there or whatever. So on the way home to where I live, a little north of Orlando, kind of past where I am at, and we hit up a record store that none of us had ever been to, and I actually don't even remember the name of it. You know what? It's not going to come to me. It was a little spot, and it seemed to be well curated. The prices were a little high, but the problem was that they used these like fixtures that they had, these very shallow shelves that would put like maybe 10 or 11 or 12 records on it, but then it would be another one underneath it, and it was very hard to flip through, and we all got pretty frustrated. Which it was just like, and even the guy who worked there, we were like, how long have you been here? And he's like, oh, 11, 12 years. And we're thinking, how have you been here this long with nobody able to really shop well? So, but we didn't want to push the issue on that. But I did look through his value section and found a couple. So I was glad to pick up these. Just a couple things I was missing, very common stuff. 4 and 4, we all know what that one is. I mean, yeah, it's surprising I didn't. I told you before, I'm rebuilding. So some of this stuff I gotta start from scratch. Like this one. I mean, this is like, oh, you're into vinyl? Here's your Welcome to Vinyl kit. But I didn't have it, so I was glad to finally find a clean copy. This one, for, because I see clean copies, but they're like, I want $15 for that. I'm like, the hell, you're gonna get that from me? Not gonna happen. So. And then, as we talked about before, I picked up the Michael Schenker Group. Here is the other one. This is just the Michael Schenker Group. This is their debut. This one is a 1980. So, another, just glad to have. Killer Shredder. Glad to finally have some more MSG. I used to play the hell out of them back in the 80s. And then I saw this one for a fiver. And you know what? This is just a killer album. It's kind of hard to say no. This is Deep Purple's Perfect Strangers. I love the title track. It's one of my favorites from Deep Purple. So very happy to pick that one up for $5. All right. So, oh man, I'm doing this pretty quickly for the amount of crap I had. I say crap. It's still crap. So, So at the beginning, you probably heard something if the editing and all worked. And I'm going to leave you with another one from this last album. So as I mentioned before, we were playing stuff for each other. We were, you know, playing, you know, we were talking about Sturgill Simpson, so we kind of played a little bit of that. And we were talking about, Infest the Rat's Nest, actually. So we played a little bit of that for Billy because he hadn't heard it. And then Billy turned us on to this kid. And I say kid, I mean, he's like, what, 23, 24? And after listening to like three songs, I'm on my phone, I'm on Amazon. I click, you know, looking, oh, they have it, hit order. And I'm like, oh, thanks, it's on the way to me. So, and that's Marcus King. So Marcus King was in the Marcus King Band, originally named. And I guess that band was a little bit more like a Southern rock feel. But this is just blues dripping with soul with a little bit of church and country thrown in there for good measure. So the one that I played for you at the beginning was a song called Wildflowers and Wine. And that one, I mean, I hear Al Green, I hear Van Morrison. I mean, the kids got it, right? And this whole album blew me away. I have like turned like, I want to say like seven people on at my office to this. And they're all like, where'd this guy come from? I'm like, I don't know, but you're welcome. The one I'm going to leave you with is another song off the first side, and that's called The Well. So check him out. It just came out this year in 2020. It's on Fantasy Records. This guy is the real, real deal. I mean, absolutely in love with this album. Because, you know, you buy stuff, and there's a label. You buy stuff, you know, you play it, you put it back in a collection, you pull it back out again. I don't see this getting put away anytime soon. I've spun this probably four or five times already since I've had it. And it's killer stuff. Be careful, because I'm pretty sure that if I listen to it again, I may get pregnant. I mean, it's just that good. So anyway, I had a wonderful time digging with you, Billy and Brad, as always. I've actually got one more video to do related to this. Billy brought me a box of like ridiculous gifts. I mean, it's just, I'm flipping through it and he's like, it's all yours, brother. And I'm just like, you've got to be losing your mind here. Said he bought a collection. There was some 80s new wave in there. And he said, you know what? I know where the home is that he's got to go. So that's going to be my next collection update. So I'm going to leave you with some Marcus King. It's on YouTube. It's on Spotify. Please go check him out. Otherwise, thanks for watching. I joke about the coughing and all, but, you know, in all seriousness, I know it's crazy out there. We're all fighting to get, you know, the things we need, but you know, hopefully everybody's well. Hopefully everybody's safe. You know what? If we're going to be stuck inside, let's watch some YouTube videos. Let's play some good music, and hopefully in 2 weeks this will all blow over. We'll see. Anyway, take care, everybody. I love you all. Thanks for watching, commenting, subscribing, making funny faces at me, whatever it is you're doing. And I'm going to shut up now. Love you. Peace.
Till the work was done. chest.